Hey guys, so just got a package in from the UPS. This is a pop order from the Disney store. So this is a pop that pertains to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. When I went there, I saw this pop. I thought it looked really cool, but it was like $25, and I was like, ah, fuck that, I'm not getting it. But they had it on sale, I think, for like $12.50, somewhere in that area. Much more reasonable price. So this character I unfortunately didn't get to see due to COVID. Pretty much everything you do at Disney right now, you have to book in advance, and yeah, they booked up pretty much immediately. This is a character that was at one of the restaurants, Oga's Cantina. And yeah, I couldn't go, but I thought this character just looked really cool. I wanted to get his pop. I do have a pin of this character from Nerd Pen, so let's get it out. They didn't pack it very well, because I mean, it's in a really big box, and the only packing they have is this paper. But it looks like it came in pretty decent condition, as far as I'm concerned, at least. Box flaps are a little bit loose, but I'm not overly picky with that. But this is DJ Rex. And I think I actually want to take this one out of the box. I'll display him in box, but I do want to take a moment to appreciate him out of the box. Looks like the bottom flap is going to come out easier, so that's the one I'll take him out with. Yeah, I think it's funny, because even though I didn't get to see him in person, I did get to see him videos of him, and I think it's funny that he's a bobblehead, because his head kind of bobbles around a lot, so that's cool. I like these arms on him, that's a nice little detail. So yeah, that's just a little pop order. Don't really get pops that often these days, but if I see one that I think is cool, I'll get it, but I'm not that big of a active Funko Pop collector. I did see a Pop and Tea combo of IG-11 that I'd like to get. I don't know if this can be exclusive anywhere, or if they're going to do like they did with that Back to the Future combo and that other Back to the Future shirt as well, where the only size they have available is extra large. That was not a smart move, Funko, because I'm not going to get it if I can't wear it. Sorry, it's not worth it just to, you know, have a shirt to do whatever with and a pop. I mean, I want to get them both. I want to be able to wear that shirt. So I sat out on that one. I'm really hoping they have my size available on this next one. A little bit crooked, and that's kind of driving me crazy, so I'm just going to touch that a little bit. Okay, but anyway, my plans today, I've been really craving Moe's, that Mexican restaurant. Still feel like I'm kind of crooked, so I'm just being really nitpicky right now. Oh well, fuck it. But anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna go to the mall. I'll probably go later. Appreciate the Christmas lights a little bit. Probably do a little bit of shopping around. I'll probably go to Barnes and Noble at least. Kind of hoping to find a Quill Pop from The Mandalorian to get signed. If not, it's not the end of the world, but yeah, like I rarely do online pop shopping. I mean, the only reason I ordered this guy was because he's so damn expensive normally, so I have to take advantage of that deal. But generally speaking, I don't order pops online. I strictly buy pops in person, so if I can't just find one somewhere, I'm not going to sweat about it. But thinking about going miniature golfing too, we'll see how I feel, because as per usual, I'm not really getting much sleep, so hopefully I'll be fairly awake later today. Not sure if I'm going to do it today or tomorrow, but I do plan on taking my car to the shop at some point this weekend. Definitely need to get a oil change and a tire rotation. And I also have a maintenance required light on. That's probably some BS, but I at least want to get that taken a look at. Most likely they'll be busy this weekend though, so I'm probably just gonna book a day for next Saturday or one of the 2 days before Christmas. Those would be the best day for me to get my car looked at. But yeah, I just like to always get my car looked at, you know, oil change and tire rotations up to date before I do a significant amount of traveling. I mean, I'm only driving 2 hours away, so I mean, it's not like it's going to be that bad. It's not going to be like the 7-hour trip I took to Orlando, but still, I mean, just to kind of play it safe, you know. Don't got anything particularly interesting to say or update about right now. I'm going to do a taste test before I finish today's vlog, but I don't think I'm going to do one right now, so. And don't think I'll be having any other mail coming in. This is a U.S. or UPS delivery, so, you know, still waiting on my regular mail, but I'm not expecting anything at least interesting today. Maybe somebody will send me a Christmas card. I'm not really expecting it, so I'm kind of doubting it. But, yeah, I'll see you whenever I do another clip. Did forget to mention one thing, but I'm going to have to show it upside down, so deal with it. But it's been 3 weeks since I got my Mandalorian Mughorn Signet tattoo. So officially through aftercare with it now. Though really, I kind of feel like it finished healing fairly earlier. The healing process for it was a lot better than my previous tattoo. Because I remember this one, the after pains of it got so bad that it was at times hard for me to sleep or be able to work with it. But yeah, this one healed up a lot faster, I felt like. There was occasional moments when it felt really bad, but for the most part, it was quite tolerable and cleared up pretty well. So, happy to have that healed up now. Hey guys, so I took my car to Pat Boys, and not too surprisingly, they were already booked up for today. So I set up an appointment for next Saturday, just a couple days before I head out on my trip, so my car should be in good condition for that. Then I went to Walmart. There's a few things I was specifically going, but then I kind of did some impulse buying. So yeah, just gonna show you some fun things I picked up. Got some Hershey's Candy Cane Kisses. I've been really craving a Hershey's Candy Cane chocolate bar, but all of a sudden I just can't find them anywhere, so I'm settling with these. They're basically the same thing. It's just I kind of prefer the texture of the thin chocolate bars to these kisses, but at least they basically taste the same. Then I got a new one. I got these Hershey's sugar cookie kisses. Usually I'm not big on sugar cookies, but I don't know, like last few weeks I've been just really enjoying sugar cookies for some reason. I will do a taste test probably for the Parma Violet candy canes that Meg sent me, but for now I'm going to do a taste test for one of these real quick since I haven't had one before. So looks like they're white chocolate based, which makes sense. I like white chocolate, so. I mean, obviously, with it being chocolate instead of a cookie, it's going to be a lot more creamier and sweeter. But, yeah, it has a nice sweetness and a nice crunch to it. So, these are really good. Got a couple movies. So, first I got Batman Death in the Family. Haven't seen this one yet. So, probably watch it at some point this weekend. And I'll do a review for it as well. This is based on the comic book of the same name, where very controversially, what was the name of Jason Todd, Robin, died at the end. And for that comic, they actually had like a vote in over whether or not Robin should die. And It was voted that he should die, but a lot of people ended up being really butthurt over it, and, you know, it ended up being a huge controversy, despite the majority of people voting that he should die. Doesn't that sound like a similar situation to what's going on right now? But anyway, yeah, I like watching a lot of these Batman animated movies that are based on the classic comics, but the last one that I watched was Hush, and that one took a lot of liberties, which at best I had mixed feelings about it, but there were a few changes that they made to it that, quite frankly, really pissed me off. That was one of the worst animated Batman movies I've seen. So hopefully this one will be a little bit more closer to the comics. I know they have a feature where, you know, you can vote if Robin lives or dies. So kind of interested in seeing how that affects the ending. So probably have to watch this a few times. I'll probably first just watch it based on him dying and see how that goes. Next, this is a movie I already have digitally, but I've been kind of lately preferring physical movies, mainly just because of my situation of viewing movies, because normally I just watch movies on my computer, but my computer's kind of dead, so I have to watch my phone. I can hook it up to my TV, but it's kind of cumbersome, because in order to have good audio, I have to have my headphones hooked up to, and then I have to be sitting in like a chair that's close to the TV, and I just feel extremely restrained doing that. So lately I've been preferring DVDs, because I can hook that up to my sound system, I can have good audio, and, you know, and I have to have headphones on and be sitting all close to the TV. But got one of my favorite Christmas movies, Polar Express, in this special gift box set. Did get a little bit of shelf wear and tear damage, but it's no big deal to me. This is only like $12. Yeah, Polar Express to me is kind of like 2001, A Space Odyssey of Christmas movies. I mean, it makes more sense than 2001, A Space Odyssey, but at the same time, I always just feel like there's some sort of like poetic, allegorical meaning behind it that's just not really picking up on me. I'm particularly fascinated by how Tom Hanks portrays like every character in it. I feel like that's supposed to represent something, like maybe possibly like the way how you receive Christmas through different stages of life. I don't know. Somehow I feel like every character he portrays is supposed to be the same person symbolically. I don't know. The hobo character particularly fascinates me. But yeah, so we got a DVD and digital cards. I may have just shown the code for. No big deal to me, but got the DVD. Really interested in how it has this bell included with it. That's the main reason why I wanted to get it. Then I've got a button set. I think I'm gonna add these to my Christmas jacket, actually. So we've got a few days I can wear that and it be relevant. And we got a couple of magnets. So I can get this out. So make sure I'm holding it right side up. These two. So yeah, in my opinion, I mean, just the DVD alone is worth the price. And Thomas, please don't knock over my camera. He does not jump onto my table, but this bell is a really cool touch. And, you know, these other items, I mean, no big deal to me, but hey, nice little freebies as far as I'm concerned that they threw in. Please don't play with this, Thomas. I'm just being really clumsy right now. I'm just dropping everything. Last thing that I got, the most expensive thing I got, probably shouldn't have got this, but I really wanted to. They got a NECA King Kong figure now. How cool is that? It's got a head swap and two different hand swaps. And I think they did a strangely good job of just making him look really huge. I'm not entirely sure which King Kong movie this is supposed to be featured on. Doesn't really have any read-up on him. I kind of feel like there should be some sort of read-up, but yeah, I mean, I don't care, man. King Kong, I love me some King Kong. I've seen every King Kong movie. So yeah, I know my mail recently arrived. Like I said, I'm not really expecting anything, so don't expect another mail haul. But maybe there will be. Who knows? That is the mystery for right now. But yeah, I still need to go to the mall to get dinner, but I'm waiting to do that later so I can, you know, enjoy some Christmas lights. So I will see you then.